Missing someone with all your heart. Missing someone with. Hey guys, welcome back to another video. It's Whatabook here, and in today's video, I'm going to show you guys how I grew my Raw High collection. So if you guys don't know, I am a Raw High collector. I try to collect everything in Raw High. I'm not very good at it. The one thing that I really don't collect is Halos, just because overpricing, and it's just a lot to dive into. And I do talk about that a lot in today's video, so just like a little heads up. But yeah, I'm gonna show you guys how to grow your Raw High collections just like I did. And so, just so you guys know, I don't accept free gifts and stuff like that. I always give something back, or I always like buy it for diamonds or whatever. So yeah, I am not one of those people that just get free gifts and stuff. I always like am spending stuff. I don't just get stuff for free. So before you think that, yeah, I have grown my collection purely out of me diamond hunting and just selling items and stuff like that. But yeah, I'm really excited for you guys to see this video, and let's get straight into it. Okay, so the first step that I'm gonna give you guys is I bought every single game pass. And you might be like, okay, but like I don't really want to buy every single game pass because it's not all worth it. And I have made a video on all the game passes that I recommend you guys for like which, but I'm just gonna give a short rundown on the ones for the best for diamond hunting and just getting diamonds. And those would be Faster Flying, Double Diamonds, and Quadruple Diamonds. And I know Quadruple Diamonds is so expensive, but if you have the extra money, please just get it. If you're into collecting and if you're really into Raw High, it's one of the best multipliers, especially with the double diamonds. Like, if those two are basically all you need, and the Faster Flying just gives you a little bit more of an advantage because you can get diamonds faster than other players, and also you can just do stuff faster. So that is why I think those two are great. But you know, if you can only afford two, then just get the Quadruple and Double. But if you have a little bit more extra money to spend, get the Faster Flying. I'm telling you, it's so like, it helps so much. Like, you know, if you just want to get to places faster when you're diamond hunting, you can go and collect those diamonds faster. And it's just a lifesaver, to be honest. Like, when you're in a public server, you can get the diamonds before people, even though it's kind of mean, but it really does help out. And yeah, I really would recommend those three. But if you don't have the money, just get the two diamond multipliers. And that goes on to my next tip, and that is log in for daily rewards and to spin the wheel. So I know you guys, I've talked about daily rewards all the time. It's basically just every day you log in, you get free diamonds. It's that. I mean, yeah, you may break the streak, but that's fine because you're still going to get diamonds even if you log in, no matter what. And now for spinning the wheel, I'm going to spin the wheel while I talk because I have not spent it today. But spinning the wheel is just, it gives you free diamonds. And yes, you may not get items, and I know everyone wants items, but it also just gives you diamonds. Like, 300 diamonds is quite a bit if you think about it. Although you might get nothing like I just did, but it's still worth it because you're still going to get something. You're not going to lose like the fountain. The fountain, I feel like it's kind of like, if you really have like, if you have like 100,000 diamonds, I would say just go for the fountain. But if you know you're kind of low, I wouldn't say go for it right now. But if you're kind of up there, like right now, honestly, I feel like I'd be fine with going to the fountain. I don't have a lot of diamonds for usual for me, because I just bought, like, I haven't been on Raw High in a while. But those are like two things that guarantee you diamonds, and one thing that either you lose or you gain, or just get XP or something, which is also great. But yeah, those two are big helps, because sometimes, you know, you just feel lazy and you don't want to diamond hunt, and yeah, you just get free diamonds for literally doing nothing. And that's what is the great thing about it. Moving on to our next tip is I stay in servers when I'm AFK. So like, sometimes I'll just go and do something like watch a YouTube video, and I'll just stay in here because then my energy will go down. So if you guys don't know, we have energy right here. So once that is, it takes about 20 to 30 minutes, I believe, to make it go completely zero energy. And so then you just go and sleep and then you get XP. And then when you level up, you get diamonds. For me, since I have all the diamond multipliers, you get 1800 diamonds, which is why I love the diamond multipliers, because guess what? I say AFK and I get that many diamonds. That's insane to me. So yeah, that is one of the one things I do. And also going along with that, when I stay AFK, like after I film these videos, I usually go and like collect these diamonds. As you can see, there's like a bunch of diamonds just laying around the map. So, you know, then you just get those diamonds. And yes, it might be kind of difficult if you don't have a private server, but it's still worth it. And like sometimes if you just go into a public server and you just, you know, just look around to see if there are diamonds, sometimes there are, so then you can just server hop. But if you're gonna do that, it's better to just go into a actual game of the castle. What am I talking about? What is it called? I'm like blanking right now. Of the campus. Yes, the campus. I cannot think of words. But moving on to my next tip is setting up times to diamond hunt. So I don't mean like, you know, hey, I'm gonna write this down right now, like at 6 p.m. today, I have to diamond hunt. I mean, if you're bored, if you know you're not gonna be doing anything, diamond hunt. Yes, you may like get distracted or something, so that may come into the time when you're like, hey, right now I'm gonna diamond hunt, I'm not gonna do anything. Like maybe if you only have an hour of Rawhide to play every single day, maybe take, not Rawhide, of Roblox to play, maybe you only have that 1 hour screen time, then take 30 minutes and then just diamond hunt. Spend that 30 minutes diamond hunting instead of, you know, just be like, oh well, I can't do that because I didn't think of it, you know. It's way better to at least just take a little bit of your time. It's way better to log into Rawhide and get those diamonds than not log in at all and get diamonds. So think about that, okay? That's basically kind of it for that tip. Just logging in and diamond hunting is better than not diamond hunting at all. And just logging in for the rewards is better than not logging into the game at all. So moving on to my next tip. I have private servers as one, and I know that not a lot of people have money to buy private servers. And so before I had private servers, I would ask my friends to be like, hey, is it fine if I borrow your private server just so I can diamond hunt? And they were fine with it. And I get that some people like just friend random people and then just use their private servers, but honestly, I feel like that's kind of mean. Like, I want to have people who like I genuinely know to use their private servers. I wouldn't go around just asking random people, but I know some people are fine with that. But for me, I don't feel comfortable doing that. But if you do feel comfortable doing that, I guess you could, you know, just ask random people if you can use the private servers, or just friend random people. Like if you have a 200 friends list that all play Rawhide, there's a good chance that at least one of them, you know, has a private server. Like for example, I only have like 30 friends and about 5 of them have private servers, so it is really nice. And also there are tons of people who just offer free private servers, like Cybernova, I know, for example, and Casio. So yeah, tons of people just have free private servers, and so just try to look for that. And yeah, and if you can't afford a private server, I really would recommend it because it really does help out a lot. So yeah, moving on to my next tip, I have plan out on what collections you want to focus on. So I have, the only collection I have completed is, this must move out of the way, I only have all of the heals, okay? And that is because I set my mind to these, okay? I wasn't, you know, I was like, okay, I know these are gonna be kind of easier because, you know, they're all on sale except for the chicken heels, and I know not a lot of people want to buy chicken heels, so it would be way easier for me to collect these heels rather than, you know, just collecting the skirts, for example, because I know there are some difficult skirts. Now maybe you want to collect every single skirt except for the legacy ones, because I know some legacy ones are very expensive, okay? They're kind of insane. But yeah, I just set my mind to be like, okay, I want to finish this collection and this is what I want to do. And also, when you're buying items, okay, so I know sometimes there are some like right now we have these summer items for sale and they only have a certain amount of time on them. And so what I would do is, and I know we have some for Christmas, for winter, Christmas, winter, same thing, Halloween, you know, spring, there's like so many. But what I would do if I were you, I would focus on the ones currently on sale. And then once you get all of those, then go back and buy them. Because chances are by the time you get finished with yours, the current one, then you're probably gonna be like, oh, it's closer to the next season, so then you can buy that, because all of the items are like, there's almost a guarantee that they're going to go back on sale. And if you really are worried, and if it really is your dream item, then you should go for it. But honestly, I would just recommend going for the ones currently on sale and then going back for items, or just waiting it out. Because like, if you really 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 want to get the Royal Rebel set, it's going to come back on sale. If you really, really, really want the Darling Valentina set, it's going to be back on sale in February. So just keep that in mind and don't buy stuff that is overpriced. I cannot stress this enough. There are people selling halos for like a million diamonds out there. And let me tell you, it's not worth a million diamonds. Okay, I am so sorry. Halos are so beautiful, but overcharging is insane. Like the Royal Rebel skirt, it goes on sale for so much. That's what you guys tell me all the time. And you know how much that skirt is? Let's check right now. It is only 28,000 diamonds, okay? So just be patient and wait. You know, it's not gonna, my collection, it didn't get started like until like I have been playing. Okay, so I've been playing Raw High for, that's not where I see my journal. I have been playing Raw High now for almost 3 years. Okay, 2 years, 8 months, 4 months, so it makes it 3 years, okay? And I didn't start my collection until last year, because if you see my old videos, I basically had nothing. And the reason why I gained so much is because I just stayed patient and I bought the items that were currently on sale rather than focusing on the past items. And I feel like that is something where Raw High players genuinely just mess up everything when it comes to their collection. And enough of that rant, we're gonna move on to the next one. It is selling extra items and try to get extra limited items. So for example, the Royal Rebel, I'm not saying overprice it, but I'm saying maybe if it's off sale, then you can sell it for a little bit more, maybe 5k or 10k more. I feel like that's still kind of overpricing, but like I'm saying, just try and buy extras of items. For example, for the parasol, people buy so much for that. But once again, please don't overprice. I personally don't like to use this method just because it leads into a lot of overpricing. But yeah, just buying extra items. And for example, the Halloween items. So if you guys don't know, like the Halloween extra items, like these, the ones that we got from like the candy hunt. And then last year, I don't remember the tax that we had last year. I feel like it was chest. But I don't really remember, but I have a bunch of extra of these and I could just sell them, like honestly, and I can make so much money off of them. Or you could just trade them for other items that you need. And yeah, that's basically it. You can get so many, like I have so many extras and I could sell those off or just trade them. And yeah, it really is a nice way of making just a little bit of extra diamonds. And yeah, and it just, it's fun because you get more items to have and you get more items, you know, to trade with. And I personally think trading is one of my favorite things, except for the overpricing. And I'm gonna stop mentioning overpricing now because I know you guys are probably annoyed. But anyways, let's move on. Actually, no, that was my last tip. Okay, so that's my last tip. Yeah, I'm sorry for this video being kind of a mess. I really just kind of wrote down extra stuff because I was like, I know you guys really, really want to grow your collections and I really want to see your guys' collections. So please tag me on Twitter and show me guys your guys' current collections and like maybe in like show where you started off and now where you are, something like that. I really want to see you guys' current collections because I love to see you guys grow your collections because it's one of my favorite things because I know you guys really appreciate me helping you. But yeah, that's gonna be it for this today's video. Make sure you like, subscribe, share, some content. Comment down below if you learned anything new to helping you grow your collection or if you plan on using any of these tips. And also comment down below any future video ideas that you guys want me to do. And also subscribe because we are super, super, super close to 5,000 subscribers and I would really appreciate it. And I might be doing a giveaway on the new set if I reach 5,000. So yeah, I would really appreciate it. And yeah, that's going to be it for today's video. I hope you guys all enjoyed and I hope you guys all have a very awesome day. And I just hit the mic. And yeah, I'll see you guys next time. Goodbye.